What up, y'all? Candy back with another how-to video coming to you straight from quarantine. Today we'll be changing out the interior lights, known as the door lights, on the Miata to LEDs. This is a complete detailed video on how to do it, whether you're fixing them, whether you're replacing the lights, whether you're changing some LEDs, whether you just want to restore them. That's all going to be covered in this video. Now, due to the quarantine, I can't be showing you guys the type of mods I want to. I had some halo lights supposed to come in, but due to this epidemic, the shipment is going to be delayed. So you guys are going to get the how-to video as soon as I can get it out to you. In the meantime, let's get straight into the video. Alright, all you're going to need to do is replace that light. Get yourself a flathead. We'll go over what type of light shortly in the video. All you're going to want to do is get your flathead, stick it right in between, and push ever so slightly. I barely put any effort into that. Put it on the other side and bend it over ever so slightly. And there you go. It should come right up. Now, if you're just replacing the lights, go ahead and flip it over to the back side. You're gonna wanna get your flathead and put it right in between right there and turn it whichever way. Since I'm gonna be showing you a complete video, it's easier just to take the whole assembly out. So I'm gonna show you guys how to do that real quick. And that's just by simply pushing out the tab. You see, you actually have to take off this ugly ass foam, but it's being held on by this tab. As soon as you push it in, you can slide it right out. Okay, to take off the driver's side, the harness actually comes all the way out, which makes it super easy, but the passenger side doesn't come out of the way and it actually stays all the way up there. So to remove it, we're actually gonna have to take out the glove compartment, which is just held on by two bolts underneath, one right there and one directly across. All right, after you remove those two bottom bolts, the glove compartment should come right out. Okay, from here you go right inside. You can actually see the harness right there. It's covered in that ugly foam, so I'm not gonna record me taking it off because it's a really tight spot. You're really just trying to push on that tab and release the harness like I showed you. You might have to rip off the phone, you might not. Just try to get it off.
Okay, so this harness is super hard to take off with all this ugly foam around. But you're going to want to try to uncover where the tab is, which is right there. And you're going to want to stick a flathead in, just like that, and turn it. So that way you pop the tab out. Okay, so if you're just replacing the light, like I said, get your flathead and put it right between those two tabs. And you're going to turn a certain way. And the door should just fly right off. From there, we get a look at the entire assembly, and the light is just being held on by two tabs, one on either side, so you're just gonna wanna push out. There you go. It was recommended to me to get a 31mm LED, but as you can see, it wasn't the right size. It doesn't matter, because all we gotta do is push those tabs back, and we can fit on the new 31mm LED.
So if you're just replacing the light, all you gotta do is get the OEM and put it right back in the way you took it out and put the home assembly back together if you didn't unplug it. Like I said, we're doing a whole restoration. So first thing we're gonna do is get this foam off, and what you're gonna need is some rubbing alcohol and a microfiber towel. I actually have this in a little spray ball, which is gonna help you out. You don't need to, you can just put it straight onto the microfiber towel. I'll show you guys how to use it right now. First thing you wanna do is get rid of as much foam as you possibly can. This can be done by just simply ripping it off, and try to get as much as you can before you go with the alcohol. Okay, as soon as you remove as much foam as you can, go ahead and get your alcohol and spray one side at a time. Use your microfiber cloth and rub it off as strong as you can. Make sure you try not to get any alcohol on the connectors. And there you go. Actually, on both my lights, the red wire actually came off. So if I can't successfully solder this, then I can always just tuck it into that underneath that copper tab. But since I have a solder and since I already have it unconnected in my room, I'm gonna try to resolder it. Alright, but the next thing you want to do is unscrew that bolt right there, and you're gonna want to hold your slider while you do that. Okay, so at this point, just grab you some sandpaper. This is some 1500 grit, some Q-tips, and alcohol. The whole point of what you're trying to do is you're trying to clean the mating surface. These connectors are filled with grease and just corrosion from the time it's been in the car. So we're trying to clean all that up. Spray the alcohol onto the Q-tip. Don't ever spray it onto here. Go ahead and rip off a piece of sandpaper, and you're just trying to get in between right there. Wherever you see copper, try to get that as clean as possible. Try to use a combination with the alcohol Q-tip and the sandpaper. Just get it all clean. All right, got the connecting surfaces all cleaned up. Look like a bright, nice copper. I also soldered the wires on both them back. It was pretty easy. I used this little soldering iron that I got at Harbor Freight for like, I think it was like $10. So it worked pretty good.
All right, after you have all the mating surfaces cleaned, go ahead and reinstall it. Go ahead and get your copper panel switch thing, whatever you want to call it. And you're going to want to bend it, not in the middle where the hole is, but towards the outside. So you have a slight bend like that. After that, go ahead and reinstall it. Roxanne, all she wanna do is party all night. Perfect. After that, you're gonna see these two tabs on the inside, and you got 31 millimeter. You're gonna wanna bend these kind of dramatically. So go ahead and put your finger, they're very easy to bend, and just press downwards. And you're just bending the tabs. Cool. Go ahead and get your new bulb or LED. Of course, the product link is in the description below. You see the circle on each tab. You're gonna wanna get the point and place it in there and try to wiggle it in. Since this is bigger, it's gonna take some force, so don't worry about it. She from Malibu, Malibu. If you ain't got a foreign, then she laugh at you. Okay, after you're done, it should look just like that. As you can tell, these are red. Now, before installing the screen, I'm gonna go ahead and clean it with some alcohol. Go ahead and reinstall your screen. It just snaps into place. And you wanna tilt your LED facing downwards. That way you can see it more. There you go. There you go. You just restore your two interior lights. Time to install them.
All right, y'all. All you're gonna wanna do is reconnect that harness you see right there in the back. Ooh, it already turned on. No key needed. And you're just gonna wanna push it back in. There you go. Damn, 10 LEDs my ass. Hopefully it's brighter at night. I've been getting screwed over with these LEDs lately. All right, after your lights are put back, the last step is to put your glove compartment back together. And that's just simply clicking it back into the top and re-screwing the two bolts back in the bottom. And that's really all it takes. Let's get some video of how it looks like at nighttime. Met her at a party in the hills, yeah. She just wanna do it for the thrill, yeah. Shorty drive a poodle with no top. But if I throw this money, she gon' drop. Ayy. She don't wait in lines if it's too long. She don't drive the whip unless the roof fall. Only wanna call when the cash out. Only take the pick when the ass out. She from Malibu, Malibu. If you ain't got a foreign, then she laugh at you. What's happening, YouTube? Yesterday was Easter Sunday. Hope y'all had an amazing Sunday. Guys, if you haven't yet, please go check out my Instagram. It's gonna be flashing right here. It's also gonna be in the link to the description below. I'll be posting on there on the daily, so go ahead and check it out. Most of the stuff I post is bonus footage, so it's stuff you wouldn't see in the video. Like right now on my lives and on my highlights, I'm gonna be addressing rattling you're gonna be hearing in Miatas. Also, you guys will be the first to see the thumbnails days before I even upload the video. I wanna let you guys know I read all comments and all DMs. Big shout out to Storm Garage for showing all the love. I appreciate you, man. I need y'all to go ahead and subscribe because you know we coming on the weekly. My halo lights did come in, but unfortunately it's been raining like stupid over here. But these next 2 weeks I have some pretty cool interior mods. Next week is just going to be a tutorial on how to remove some panels inside the interior. That way when I actually do the mods, I don't really have to go into depth on how to take it off, because the last week video is going to be detailed video on how to remove all the parts. So hopefully you guys like it. The mod I'm going to do, I've never seen it done on any Miata or actually any car, and I did go looking around YouTube for it, so it should be cool. It should be original. It should be something y'all's never seen before. As for the LED lights, they're pretty cool. Excuse my messy car. I have them on the door setting and they're pretty responsive. I like them a lot. Anyway, y'all, thank y'all so much for watching. I'll see you guys next week.